Welcome back, investors, to Ticker Time News. I'm Adam, and here's the latest segment from the After Hours show. Over 2021, Taiwan Semi was range-bound. A bottom around $108, a top around $124. And it could not break out. A deep dive on Taiwan Semi, ticker symbol TSM. Taiwan Semi had a fabulous into fiscal year 21, as its revenue growth reached over 20% year over year in Q4, a return to growth rates not seen since Q3 of 2020, over a year ago. Growth for the chipmaker's bottom line was also strong. Earnings rose 16% year over year, topping estimates by double digits. With stocks selling off one day and gaining the next, wouldn't it be great to know what the top 10 stocks are in categories like value, growth, dividend, and momentum? Well, great news. We just uploaded our top 10 stocks list for each of those four categories. That's over 40 high-quality stocks ready to choose from that are constantly updated, so you always have the best names available. Click the first link in the description and become a member to get instant access to our top 10 value, growth, dividend, and momentum stocks, and so much more. We've done the research so you don't have to. Being the world's most valuable and largest semiconductor manufacturer, Taiwan Semi paints a really good picture of the overall semiconductor industry through its earnings report. As such, one of the most notable comments from Taiwan Semi during its Q4 earnings call is that it expects capacity to remain tight throughout 2022, even as in markets such as automotive, PC, data centers, and mobile are creating products with higher silicon content. Despite this tight capacity, Taiwan Semi predicts the foundry industry should grow close to 20% for the year. Taiwan Semi is optimistic that it will outperform this expected industry growth. Another takeaway from Q4 is that operating margins grew by 50 basis points year over year, slightly ahead of Taiwan Semi's guidance of 41.7%. Even more remarkable, the company expects margins to continue to improve in fiscal year 22, forecasting a range of 42 to 44%. The low to mid percentage growth across most of Taiwan Semi's business units contributed to the decent margin improvement in the quarter. One highlight came in from the automotive side, where revenues jumped 10% year over year. Although automotive only accounts for 4% of total Q4 revenues, the jump is significant, as it shows that the automotive industry is continuing on in its path of recovery. Not only is the growth much higher than the minor 5% jump last quarter, but it also builds upon a leap of 27% already achieved in the year-ago period. Looking ahead, I think a big contributor to the stock's movement today, along with the company's expectations for continued margin expansion in fiscal year 22, is Taiwan Semi's Q1 revenue guidance. The company expects revenue of between $16.6 and $17.2 billion for the quarter, totally smashing estimates. High performance computing, or HPC, is expected to be the driver behind sales growth, coupled with further factory recovery in automotive. Both should more than offset Taiwan Semi's forecast of a milder smartphone season compared to recent years. Lastly, Taiwan Semi predicts that 5G and HPC applications will be major themes over the long term. Both industries should ignite a further jolt in the smartphone, automotive, and Internet of Things markets, just like I said in the Catalyst Watch video. given the enhanced capabilities of 5G and HPC enabled. Taiwan Semi is thus guiding to long-term revenue in U.S. dollars between 15 and 20% over the next several years. Overall, Taiwan Semi's Q4 results point to increasing demand for chips in many additional applications moving forward. I also like seeing that the automotive industry is continuing to recover. Although I was slightly concerned about Taiwan Semi's efforts to seemingly stockpile chips in the previous quarter, I did say that 3 months ago, given that a downturn could result in substantial losses of product, the company is continuing to secure payment from its customers, reducing this risk in the process. The bottom line, I believe 5G and HPC themes should play out nicely in fiscal year 22, setting up Taiwan Semi for a very strong year ahead. But what do you think about Taiwan Semi and their chips? Are they doing the right thing? Are they moving in the right directions? And do you see these same themes playing out in 22? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching this segment from the After Hours Show. If you want to watch it live, then join me on this channel every day the market is open around 5 p.m. for the latest stock market news, deep dives on your favorite ticker symbols, and most importantly, answer your questions. Make sure to click the like button and share this video with others so we can all reach financial freedom. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.